So today we'll be taking a look at a few stories involving Bobby Lashley, Batista, Randy Orton, and Daniel Bryan. Let's start things off with a brief new update on everything with Daniel Bryan. Last time we talked about Daniel Bryan, we sort of figured the match with Roman Reigns was his last match for a while, and that he was looking for a more part-time schedule. Well, there's been a lot of new information released over the last few days. Not only was his match with Roman Reigns his last SmackDown match, but it's now being reported that it was his final WWE show for his old contract. Reports are claiming that Daniel Bryan's current WWE contract expired sometime last week, and SmackDown was his last official show. Daniel Bryan is now released from that WWE contract since it expired and is technically a free agent that can sign anywhere he so pleases. So Daniel Bryan being a free agent instantly makes him one of the hottest free agents out there. It's also being reported that Daniel Bryan didn't talk about his contract status much, and he didn't have a whole big farewell. So that alone has some fans wondering if that's a sign that he will be back with WWE. There's even more reports that claim AEW would like to obviously sign Daniel Bryan, but that they feel like he's also heading back to WWE. There's also word that WWE may be willing to overpay Daniel Bryan with a massive deal, even if it's extremely part-time, just to keep him away from AEW. This was sort of the same situation with Edge, and he has even discussed it in recent interviews as well. The second Edge got cleared, he was listening to deals from both sides, and WWE ended up offering the better deal. So Edge went with WWE. That may be what Daniel Bryan does as well. Maybe shop himself around as a free agent for a while, listen to what everyone has to offer, and then come back to WWE to see if they can match it or even beat those other offers. That seems like the basic idea for what we can expect Daniel Bryan to do here in the coming months. Everyone thought that Daniel Bryan still had more time on his contract because of how they said that he was just banished from SmackDown. We all thought, okay, maybe he goes to Raw or NXT, and that can still be the case, but it looks like he'll have to reach a new agreement with WWE first. That's the latest news on Daniel Bryan for the time being, but this is going to be an interesting situation to keep an eye on for sure. What are your thoughts on Daniel Bryan's situation? And where do you want to see him sign to next? Batista and Bobby Lashley went trending this week after they linked up together and teased a possible match. Batista had said several times that he's legitimately retired and won't ever return, like the same way all the retired wrestlers do. But that still didn't stop Bobby Lashley and fans to wonder about what a dream match would look like between the two of them. Bobby Lashley took to Instagram to post the pictures with Batista and tease a WWE title match between the two of them and had this to say. So good seeing my friend Batista, and yes, I will give you a title shot if you ever return. Nevertheless, congrats on all your success, brother. He posted that caption with a few recent pictures of them together in a parking lot. That post did bring in some big numbers for Bobby Lashley, especially given the caption as well. No one ever expects Batista to really get back into the ring because of how strongly he wants to stick to the fact that he's retired, but the fans had a lot of fun discussing what that title match between Bobby Lashley and Batista would look like. As far as Bobby Lashley goes, he's been a phenomenal WWE champion so far. He's just this dominant champion that seems to be unstoppable. The win over Drew McIntyre and making him pass out at WrestleMania was a huge win for Lashley, and everyone expects his WWE title reign to be a lengthy one. Similar to how everyone feels like Roman Reigns' title reign is leading towards a big return, like The Rock. Everyone seems to believe that Bobby Lashley's title reign could also be leading towards a big blockbuster return and match. Of course, it's not a secret anymore. Everyone, including Lashley himself, has been talking about Brock Lesnar versus Bobby Lashley. Bobby Lashley has been very vocal about his desire to work with Brock Lesnar for many years now, but this story was just never there. But now, you can sort of see the possible story unfolding right in front of us as long as Lashley keeps dominating on Raw. If Lashley truly takes out everyone on Raw and starts bragging that there's no one left to beat, no one is on his level, that could kick open the door for a Brock Lesnar return and feud. Everyone seems to be on board to see that matchup as well. The majority of fans seem actually excited for that potential match. Brock Lesnar is currently on his longest break away from the WWE since he returned in 2012, and that was most likely due to the fact that they don't want to spend the money on him if there's no worthy opponent or story. But now, we can actually see this story being written for WWE. So it actually makes sense if Lashley finally catches Brock Lesnar's attention. The one downside to this matchup is, of course, if Brock Lesnar wins. A lot of fans have pointed out that Raw would be even more dreadful if the WWE champion went missing for 6 months. So that's one negative. Fans just don't want to deal with Brock Lesnar's extremely limited appearances on Raw, where he just jogs in place for 3 minutes every 3 to 6 months. And it's a good point. So if Lashley wins and defeats Brock Lesnar, that'll probably be the best way to get the matchup. But avoid another title reign from Brock. But then again, Brock is coming off a loss in the main event of WrestleMania, so can he really afford to lose another match? Well, Brock Lesnar is always going to be Brock Lesnar, even if he's on a small losing streak. But it is still something to consider. But what are your thoughts on those two potential matchups for Bobby Lashley? Would you like to see him face Batista or Brock Lesnar? Randy Orton and WWE stole a storyline from another superstar. This story comes from former WWE superstar TJP. TJP was a member of the Cruiserweight division a few years ago. He was involved with some storylines and was even champion as well. TJP had this story going on where he was unmasking the Lucha House Party and basically collecting their mask. According to TJP, Vince McMahon and WWE writers loved the concept so much that they wanted to bring it to SmackDown. Their logic, according to TJP, was that no one was watching the Cruiserweight show, so they would be able to get away with duplicating his story from that show and bringing it over to SmackDown with different superstars. So that's exactly what they did. The whole unmasking and collecting masks storyline went to Randy Orton. After borrowing the idea from TJP, they gave it to Randy Orton and Rey Mysterio over on SmackDown. Randy Orton would become obsessed with unmasking and taking Rey Mysterio's masks, and they ran with that story for a while, and it all came from the inspiration of TJP's storyline. Randy Orton has since moved on from that story, and it never truly went anywhere major. Randy Orton is now in a tag team with Riddle, and they're reportedly set for a massive push on Raw. Everyone assumed that Orton would turn on Riddle after their first match, but it seems like this will be more of a long-term thing. They'll likely tag with each other for a decent while before going down this whole breakup route. Some fans have even expressed their desires to see Riddle turn first, since Orton turning on his partner is predictable and has been done numerous times in years past. If WWE wants to go for that shock factor like they usually do, fans think that a Riddle turn would actually be unexpected here for this tag team. But what are your thoughts on today's stories with Daniel Bryan, Bobby Lashley, and Randy Orton? Leave your comments, don't forget to subscribe with all notifications on, and leave a like if you enjoyed. Thanks for watching, guys.